On the men's side, 88 Olympian Lance Ringnall is shooting for his first national title. It promises to be an outstanding day of gymnastics. We'll also talk with him.
When Mary Lou Retton won Olympic gold in 1984, she launched a new era of American gymnastics. Guiding Mary Lou was Coach Bella Caroli, a Romanian who now has trained a succession of American champions, from Christy Phillips to Phoebe Mills. Brandi Johnson continued the dynasty, but after the Seoul Olympics, she left Bella, returning to her former coach, and won a national championship. Now Bella Caroli has a new generation of gymnasts, the brightest 14-year-old Kim Zemesko. America's best men and women compete today for the National Gymnastics Championship. Today we're at the Coliseum in Denver as the nation's best gymnasts gather for the biggest event of the year. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the U.S. Gymnastics Championships. I'm Joel Myers, and just a little bit later this afternoon, we'll be crowning a new champion of the men's division. On the women's side, Brandi Johnson will try to become the first back-to-back winner since 1982. You'll also see we'll be representing our country over the next 12 months as we'll be selecting the U.S. national team with the top 20 women qualifying and the top 12 men. You'll get a better idea of who you can look for down the road representing the United States, possibly the Olympic team for Barcelona in 92. Joining us on our coverage this afternoon, a coach for the U.S. team in the World Championships last year, Christy Kraft. And Christy, it could be a possible changing of the guard this afternoon in the women's division.
That's right, Joel. It should be a real battle for the women's all around. We have the experience of Brandi Johnson, the defending national champion, versus the youthful exuberance of Kim Zemesko, the 1989 junior champion. Ironically, it was Kim who unseated Brandi recently at the American Cup, and many thought Brandi would retire. She came here, she's ready to defend her title, and she looks great.
Another story that's developing today, a bit of a battle going on between the coaches.
Well, as you may know, Bella Caroli has coached 5 of the last 8 national champions, and that's an enviable statistic for any coach. The other coaches would like to thwart that effort, and the one who seems most able to do it is Kevin Brown, the coach of Brandi Johnson.
Also with us on our coverage this afternoon, a gold medal performer at the 84 Summer Games in Los Angeles, Tim Daggett. And Tim, some of them have been a bit disappointing over the last couple of years, and again today, no real definitive choice going in.
That's right, Joel. At this point, there really is no clear-cut favorite. But I feel strongly that U.S. gymnastics is on a major upswing, and we will soon be winning many international medals. The major surprise of the competition, Lance Ringnall. After 2 events, he was in 23rd position. He battled all the way back to the 5th spot. And I feel strong he could be national champion if he has a great outing today. John Roethlisberger is leading the way, and there is one word to characterize this kid, and that is tough. When the cards are on the table, he's going to perform. Chris Waller is currently in 2nd position. Many have thought for many years that Chris has the most potential, and I feel that if he has a good competition today, he could be right in there for the championship.
Noticeable by his absence, former Olympian Kurt Thomas. He was pointing towards the championships for his comeback bid.
That's right, but Kurt Thomas is not here. I think what he's done, though, he's added a spark, and these kids no longer talk about going out and having a good day. They talk about going out and winning.
So it's the biggest event of the year in U.S. gymnastics. It's the championships in Denver. And let's take a look now at the standings after the compulsories that have been completed. Roethlisberger with a slight edge over Chris Waller. Then it's Demus and Warburton tied for 3rd. Humphrey and Ringnall deadlocked in the 5th position. Well, the total overall score will determine the all-around champion. That will be comprised of the compulsory rounds worth 60% and the optional round worth 40%. New winner in the men's division, John Roethlisberger. The women are up next. Will it be a change into the guard? We'll find out when we come back to Denver.
Sports update. Up next is the women's all-around competition at the U.S. Gymnastics Championships, where 88 Olympian Brandi Johnson will try to defend her national title. But before we send you best championships... Denver.
Welcome back once again to the Coliseum in Denver. I'm Joel Myers alongside Christy Kraft. We get ready for the women's division now. It seems impossible that the heart of a champion could beat in her 70-pound frame. But already, Kim Zabesko has defeated the best in international competition. Her coach, Bella Caroli, knows that in women's gymnastics, success is short-lived. He has produced other champions, but time is the opponent that eventually vanquished them all. All but Brandi Johnson, who at age 17 persists in competing in a sport where winning Olympic medals is child's play. Though she now trains with Kevin Brown in Florida, she shared the Olympic spotlight with Caroli in 1988. With hazy dreams of future Olympics, Brandi persevered. Illness and injury contributed to her disastrous performance in this spring's American Cup. But she's not yet ready to be dismissed.
After American Cup, I just really didn't know what to expect. I went through burnout. I never thought it would happen to me, but it did. And I took some time off just to get away from it for about a week and a half. And I came back on my birthday and I said, I've been out long enough, I'm ready to go back.
Kim Zabesko performed with precocious flair and energy in winning this year's American Cup. And while her coach revels in her early success, he values the competition her generation will face with their seniors. Rivalries help transform little girls into Olympic champions. And Bella has put together a new group that could be arriving just in time for Barcelona.
I'm asking, you know, which is easier? To come with something what you already got and compete back and forth, or to go back and work really, really, really hard, gosh, to create a totally new generation? I did not strive. I was the one I chose the hard way. And all of my life, you know, I've done it the same way. Go back and create the generation. And I believe now that people should be very, very happy to have, you know, this unique situation in the country when two great generations can meet each other, can create a competitive environment, a very strong challenging each other. And who is the winner? The overall program, the quality, the team.
And if gymnasts can have rivals, then their coaches can too. Kevin Brown need look no farther than Bella Caroli.
I take Bella as a challenge. His big comment is, just come out and beat me, and then we'll see where everything stands. Well, I've done that, and I'm going to continue to do that. And I feel that because of my strengths in my programs, I think I've got some strengths that go along with my program and my athletes and the way I coach that are really beyond what Bella does. So I think we're going to see some changes. I think I've already proven myself, and I think that it'll all come out in the end, at the end of the meet.
At the compulsories, Brandi Johnson came determined to defend her title against Kim Zabesko and all other challengers. Brandi and Kim performed excellent routines, all under the watchful eyes of their coaches. Brandi showed grit, while Kim rarely wavered. But experience gained an edge as the battle shaped up. Each time Brandi hit a routine, Kim answered with one of her own. Mercy was not in Brandy's heart, needing a solid beam performance. Brandi nailed it and showed the crowd of the youngsters something about her competitive spirit. If Kim Zabesko or any other is to unseat Brandi Johnson, it will not be without a fight. So we take our first look at the standings after the compulsories, which comprise 60% of the scoring, and the showdown is heating up. Brandi Johnson with a slight edge over Kim Zabesko. Will we see our first back-to-back winner, the national championship since 1982? We'll find out as the women's optionals are coming up next from Denver. Welcome back once again to the U.S. Gymnastics Championships. I'm Joel Myers along with Christy Kraft, and we now move to the optionals in the women's division. The defending national champion, Brandi Johnson, getting ready for the vault, battling her way back over the last 4 months, Christy, from illness and injury. When you look at the overall picture, and especially Barcelona in 92, is the timetable working against Brandi Johnson?
In 1992, Brandi Johnson will be 19 years old, which is about 2 to 2.5 years older than the median age for the Olympic Games. But Brandi Johnson is no gymnast to count out. She has the talent, and I think it's a question of motivation.
It's a great event for her as she gets ready for her first vault. She won a silver medal on the vault at last year's World Championships.
That was a fabulous vault for Brandi Johnson. 1/10 deduction for a step on the landing. This is a great opportunity for Brandi to increase her lead and further her quest to retain her all-around title.
Get it up high. Get it up
high. Listening to the instructions for Coach Kevin Brown. And don't forget, in the women's vault, they go 2 times and they take the highest score. But an outstanding start in the optionals.
That was an excellent vault. Here we see Brandi. She has a strong push off the horse, laid out all the way around. Just that step on the landing.
Sigh of relief from Brandi Johnson just to get everything underway this afternoon. So much pressure on her, and a 9-8. Could have been a 9-9 without that step.
It could, but that's a nice solid start for Brandi. Remember, she's one of the best vaulters in the world.
While Brandi is getting ready for her second vault, we move over to the beam with Erica Stokes, one of Caroli's kindergarten last year that's definitely advancing in a big hurry this year.
Erica is in her first year as a senior gymnast. She's starting out on the balance beam, not the easiest situation to be in, but I think she can handle it well. She has an unusual mount, pressed a handstand, a double pirouette, twice around on her hands in a split position. It's unusual because no one really does this mount.
She's tall when you take into consideration some of the others that perform for Bella Caroli.
Yeah, she's tall to the tune of about 4'9". Two back handsprings to a layout. Oh, and a break there, but Erica holds on. She just keeps moving out of it.
Is that type of break maybe 1/10 of a point deduction?
The breaks are measured. A small break is 1/10. A major break, like a near fall, is 4/10. And breaks like that are somewhere in the middle. Erica's moving very confidently on this event, and she's setting up for one of her biggest skills, a full twisting back handspring straddle down. And that was well done. Erica proves that she's not only skilled, but also very courageous.
The balance beam is only 4 inches wide and 4 feet off the ground. And she is displaying incredible coordination.
The margin for error on this event is certainly small. Now she's preparing for her dismount, a round off double twist. Nice and clean and a good landing. That's a great start for Erica Stokes.
Another example of some of the young talent we have in the women's division. Erica Stokes is only 13 years old.
And she is talented. Here's that big skill, the full twisting back handspring to a straddle down. That was so well done. That's the skill that sets her apart from the rest of the field.
In fourth position, after the compulsories, Erica Stokes starts the optional portion of her program with a 9-5 on the balance beam. Oh, we saw the first vault of Brandi Johnson with a 9-8. They take the highest of the two. And now Brandi is getting ready for her second.
Brandi already has a good score under her belt. She's just trying to better that score with her second vault, handspring front with a half twist. Well done. Another step on the landing, but that's just 1/10 of a point.
Each vault is graded down according to the degree of difficulty, and that one could have been a perfect 10.
That's right, Joel. Brandi Johnson is one of the few athletes who performs 2 different 10.0 vaults. Here's her second vault, handspring front, half twist. Nice height, nice distance off the horse. Just a step on the landing. It was a nice job.
That was up there what needed to be.
So it seemed like it would have been tough for Brandi Johnson to improve upon a 9-8, right, but she did exactly that with a 9.85 on her second vault, and she's got very little margin of error because of that young lady that's breathing right down her neck. Kim Zumeskel getting ready for her first rotation on the balance beam.
Good physical, good action, front, good solid, and sharp.
That's not bad.
Bella's preparing Kim Zemeskal for a beam routine, preparing her to go out and attack this apparatus, which is exactly what she'll do. She is such an aggressive performer.
That beam is almost as tall as Kim Zemeskal. She's only 4'5 at 72 pounds.
Kim seems totally unfazed by the dimensions of this piece of apparatus. She's stable and consistent, which is typical of Karoly gymnasts. They're always so well prepared. Here's her first tumbling combination, back handspring to two layouts. Stuck solid.
It seems like every time we see her try a full turn, she almost loses her balance.
Kim had a break on a full turn in the compulsory competition as well. And it's ironic because she does so much difficulty in her beam routine. A full turn is a simple element. Here's Kim's second tumbling combination, flip-flop layout down to one knee. This has been a very solid performance. All she has left is her dismount, a round-off double back. Nice. A little hop on the landing. That'll cost her about 2/10.
Well done, Dad.
Well, you can tell Bella Karoly expects a great deal from his prize pupil, Christy. Did you hear that comment? It wasn't bad.
No, and it wasn't bad. I've seen Kim do better, but it's a nice, solid start for the first event. This may be one of the reasons Bella was less than thrilled with that performance. Front handspring, and then she has a little break as she goes into her Sassone jump. The dismount is important because it's the last thing that the judges see, the last impression. She has a strong round off, double back, her legs are a little apart, and then she just has to hop on that landing.
Kim Zemeskal has been so superb in recent months that when she doesn't do a 9-8, a 9-9 on certain apparatus, all of a sudden you've been spoiled. You wonder what's going wrong. And there's her score, a 9-6-7-5 of the beam, but Bella Karoly let us know that he wasn't all that pleased with a 9-6-7-5 performance. And don't forget, at the same time, she's trying to catch the defending champion, Brandi Johnson. Still in the first rotation of the optional, Shannon Miller, currently in seventh position. If you thought you saw a tiny one, Christy, in Kim Zemeskal, Shannon Miller is only 4 feet, 4 inches, weighing 60 pounds.
That's for sure, Joel. You know, it seems funny to call it women's gymnastics when you have a look at Shannon Miller. She's just 13 years old, and she's a tiny little girl. Her degree of difficulty stacks up with the very best in the world. She's going to be doing another tumbling combination, as well as a very big dismount. There's an aerial walkover, a little break there. You can see her style is a little less mature than that of Kim Zemeskal. So combination, layout, layout. Well done. Well, Shannon has all the difficulty that she needs right now, 2 years away from the Olympic Games. So she has the luxury of just concentrating on improving her execution. Here comes her dismount. The only gymnast in the United States to use this dismount. A full twisting double back. That was unbelievable.
Well, Shannon has said this is her favorite apparatus, and she looks strong on the balance beam.
Here's another look at that dismount. Many of the gymnasts use a double back for their dismount. Shannon does a double back with a full twist in the first somersault. That is a dismount that only the Soviets and Shannon Miller are even attempting in competition. That was incredible.
Shannon's an eighth grader, Summit Middle School in Edmond, Oklahoma, as she waits for her results. And it's the same score we just saw for Kim Zemeskal, a 9-6-7-5. And you can see that Bella Karoly appears to be upset with some of the early scoring so far. Let's take a look at the results after the first rotation for the women in the optionals. Brandi Johnson still with that slight lead over Zemeskal. The showdown continues in the Karoly gym doing very, very well in the early going. Some of the early scoring, it continued while
they
we were away.
Two tenths for me, and adding two tenths, another one, there are four tenths. In four tenths, I can't fight with four tenths against.
He's talking to Kathy Kelly, the National Program Director for the Women's Division.
Fight, you know, judging order of tenth, you can fight, but you can fight with the help of point.
This is exactly the kind of behavior that draws the most criticism for Bella from the coaching ranks.
He is working for what is developing down the road for his competitors.
This is a strategic move on Bella's part, letting the judges know that he is fighting for every tenth.
They don't interfere, you know, I'm leaving the competition. We can't compete in these conditions. There is no way to compete in these conditions.
And this is a process for Bella Caroli that starts long before they get to the arena. 7 a.m., the sun just beginning to burn, building into the steamy morning heat of Houston. The traffic on I-45, pyramids towards rush hour. And Caroli's gym is dynamic with energy.
Speed.
Strong!
No, that's a big difference. No. That was better.
Thus begins the day for a few devoted and capable children with their first of two rigorous, grueling, four-hour workouts.
You have to have a total dedication. You have to spend hours. You have to be focused. You have to put some sacrifices. Gosh, nothing in the world can get without sacrifices. Especially when you want to get something which is the best in the world. Gosh, you have to put the most out of you. The most, more than anybody else. That's the name of the game.
This drive and enthusiasm oozes from Caroli and is absorbed by his pupils, transferred by the famous Caroli bear hugs, and his consistent attention to detail that created talent the likes of Phoebe Mills. This is the taskmaster, the coach who created stoic young athletes, attuned to his grunts and groans. His dedication has brought forth talent like his first prodigy, 1976 and 1980 Olympic medalist Nadia Comaneci.
I had confidence in him when he told me to do something, and I knew that probably he's not so good. I said in my mind, he told me, if you do what I tell you, it'll be very good for you. That's why I had confidence, and I did whatever he told me.
One youngster who's found confidence with Caroli is Kim Zemeskal. Kim has devoted the past 8 years to the Caroli cause. And at age 14, that equals half a lifetime. Being a native of Houston, Texas, Kim is the first of a generation of American gymnasts to come entirely through the Caroli camp. Through the years, Caroli has not only molded Kim physically, but molded her mentally as well.
All the way out, and go.
It's within us. I mean, we're doing this gymnastics for ourselves, and you know, we're the ones who want to be the best. And he's there to, you know, motivate us and push us and coach us and teach us, you know, what we're doing wrong.
She's very disciplined. She's very obeying, as you could say that. She's different, I think, than my other two because of the way she's been trained at the gym. She's more disciplined in life. He's very intense with the kids.
Right,
he wants them to be perfect all the time, even in everyday workout.
Being perfect all the time is part of the Caroli technique. Routines during workouts are expected to be performed at the same level as in competition, and then are repeated over and over again. There are no surprises, no new experiences when the girls arrive at a meet. But beyond just training, there is Caroli.
It comes like a reinforcement when I'm around. But I'm not really purposely on doing anything, you know, no magic, no hocus pocus. Probably they feel the strength because they know how strong and how consistent they've been working.
I don't know what it is that if they want to do really well in his eyes. I mean, he's like God almost, you know.
All right, normal, smooth, strong, okay? No, that's it.
Exactly like in the gym, the continuing process of Bella Caroli. Final instructions. Don't do anything differently than you would normally do in the gym as Kim Zemeskal starts her second rotation on the floor where she is truly dynamic.
This is possibly Kim Zemeskal's best event. She is a powerful tumbler and an absolutely enchanting personality.
And you can hear that Caroli influence with the music in the background. Bella, of course, defected from Romania back in 1981.
Her routine was choreographed by Geza Pozar, who also did Nadia and Mary Lou Retton's routines. You can see how well she tumbles, but now watch how well she sells this routine. She is just adorable. She has a really unique pass coming up, 3 whipbacks to a double back somersault.
This is where she wrapped up her American Cup title.
1, 2, 3, flip-flop, double back. Incredible. And the crowd is really with her now.
So often the gymnasts just worry so much about their routine they forget about the crowd. But right now it's a minute and a half love affair going on between Zemesko and this crowd in Denver.
Here she's setting up for a dismount, a round off back handspring, double back. That was a great job.
Kim Zemesko nailing her dismount and coming through a big way on the floor exercise.
That is really going to put the pressure on Brandi Johnson.
Okay.
We also see a different look on the face of Bella Caroli, obviously feeling very strongly that Kim Zemesko not only came through, but maybe some of that strategy he was working with earlier will pay off in the long run, because he was upset with the early scoring.
Well, you can't be upset with this performance. Here's Kim's middle pass, round off, 3 whips, back handspring, double back. That's 5 elements on the diagonal. Most gymnasts can only fit 4. Look at that incredible height on that double back somersault. And she just nails it.
If it's possible, she looks even more confident than she did in the American Cup. And Kim told me that win in the American Cup, a major victory for her, her biggest meet thus far in the United States. And it really has carried over 4 months later. And if she was ever holding anything back, well, she doesn't have to worry about that anymore, because she's got not only the crowd in her hands, but also the judges over the last 4 to 5 months.
Kim has really matured into a strong all-around competitor.
Waiting for results on the floor exercise, a 9-8 for Kim Zemesko. That will move her even closer to Brandi Johnson, the leader after the first rotation. Brandi is getting ready now for the uneven bars. We'll see if she can hold that lead over Zemesko when we come back to Denver. In place after the first rotation, Elizabeth Aquino, Betty Aquino from Caroli's gym, ready for the floor exercise.
Betty Aquino is such a beautiful dancer on this event, but also she is a strong tumbler. She opens with a full twisting double back. Nice and solid.
We're watching a relative unknown in the gymnastic circles. As far as international competition, she has very little experience on the international level. Born in Africa, then moved to Romania and came to the United States when she was only 2. She is so graceful.
Betty Aquino was not even a member of the junior team, and she has just taken the senior scene by storm. Here's her second pass, a double pike. Another great job.
When we came to Denver, Christy, all we heard was, look out for the Caroli six-pack. And she's a prominent member of that six-pack.
Like Kim Zemesko, Betty Aquino is a gymnast with really no weaknesses in the all-around. She finishes with a round-off back handspring, double back. Another great performance.
Outstanding dismount by Betty Aquino. You'll be hearing a lot about this young lady in the near future. Look for her to be a possible member of our Olympic team in Barcelona in 92.
Generally, it's a real disadvantage for an athlete to come into a national championship without credential and without a lot of previous experience. But Betty Aquino is so strong and so good and so consistent in the all-around that she's doing well in spite of the odds.
Waiting for the score of Betty Aquino. We move to our leader after the first rotation. Brandi Johnson getting ready for the uneven bars. And there's that 9-6-7-5. A nice score, an outstanding one for Betty Aquino. So another solid performance from one of the members of Bella Caroli's gym. And our leader after the first rotation, Brandi Johnson on the uneven bars, where she had problems at the meet in March of the American Cup.
This is the event that started Brandy's demise in the American Cup. And it started with this skill, a reverse hack. Very well done. Now, she's changed her routine since the American Cup. She's omitted one of her releases, opted for a nice, safe, clean routine. Full pirouette giant. Oh, she almost didn't make it over there. A double tuck dismount.
So essentially, you feel it was a safe one, but not a spectacular routine.
Basically, Brandi's routine had all of the required moves, and it was well done, but nothing really extraordinary. I think it'll be enough to hold her in the all-around.
So she didn't take any chances on the uneven bars. Let's find out if she maintains her lofty position. With her completion of the second rotation on the uneven bars.
Speaking of lofty positions, Brandi really takes some air on this reverse hex. She has one of the biggest reverse hex in the competition.
Good form displayed, but as she proceeds through this routine, there are no major flaws, but she's not at the same time taking any chances to gain that extra tenth or two-tenths of a point.
That's right, Joel. I think it'll be enough to hold her in her position, but she won't pick up anything. Brandi may be thinking about the last 12 months where she's had some serious problems on this event, both in the American Cup and the World Championships. So she's opting to play it safe. Here's a double tuck dismount, nice and clean, but again, not spectacular.
So Brandi Johnson trying to hold off the challenge of Kim Zemeskal, waiting for her score on the uneven bars. And a 9-5. Well, basically what you would expect from a routine where she played it safe. So there's no doubt Zemeskal has started to close the gap on Brandi Johnson, and another one who's making a charge. Currently in fourth, Erica Stokes, also from Bella Caroli's gym.
Here's Erica Stokes' first pass, a layout pike double back. She was plenty high on that skill, had a little bit of trouble with the landing.
Bella told me Erica reminds him a great deal of Julianne McNamara. Very strong, also very coordinated.
And Erica is similar to Julianne McNamara in that her strong events are the skill events, bars and balance beam. And she has a little bit of trouble on the floor exercise and vaulting. Tumbling pass, one and a half twist, through to a double twist. Well done.
And like the other members of Bella Caroli's gym, she really knows how to play to the crowd.
That's right, Joel. By the end of this routine, the crowd is always right behind Erica Stokes, and she needs that going into her last pass. Round off back handspring, double back.
Good finish for Erica Stokes.
That was a good job for Erica.
Another strong performance by a member of Bella Caroli's gym. As we have completed now the second rotation. And so many have been talking about the overall dominance of Caroli in the sport in the United States. It truly is continuing after two rotations here this afternoon.
This is Erica's middle pass, round off back handspring, one and a half twist, right into a round off back handspring double twist. She's one of the few gymnasts in this competition to use that combination, and she does it so well.
Just barely staying in bounds. You're on the white. With that back of the foot, it's a tenth of a point deduction. As you can see, Erica Stokes is being told at this time by Kim Zemeskal how close she was to losing a tenth of a point. 9-5-5 for Erica Stokes on the floor exercise to enhance her position. And when you look at the top five, Brandi Johnson's lead has been trimmed down now to only 0.05 of a point. Zemeskalin second, Aquino third, Woolsey fourth, Stokes fifth. Three of the top five are from Bella Caroli's gym. We'll be right back. We welcome you back to the Coliseum in Denver for the U.S. Gymnastics Championships. The youngest competitor just turned 13 this past March. Shannon Miller, currently sixth after two rotations.
Shannon Miller is not much taller than the vaulting horse. She can do a really big vault. That was a beautiful layout pull. Very well done. A little hop on the landing. She is going to be right in there for 92.
Extremely smooth. She discusses things with her coach from Edmond, Oklahoma, Steve Nuno. And it really looks like the timetable could be a perfect one when you talk about 92 for someone like Shannon Miller.
Shannon Miller is a part of the youth movement, along with Kim Zemeskal, Erica Stokes, and company. Here's her vault. Nice layout full, good clean vault, and she really gets some nice distance on that vault.
So Shannon Miller with a 9.675. Good score to start off with for Shannon Miller on her third rotation. Now, as we talk about Shannon Miller and the timetable for Barcelona in 92, we look across the way to Sandy Woolsey. She gets ready for her mount of the balance beam, currently fourth. And as solid as she has been over the last couple of years, you wonder if maybe a performer like Sandy is getting caught in the middle, maybe peaking a little bit too early for Barcelona in 92 because of the youth movement.
Sandy finds herself as one of the veterans in this competition. She was a member of our world championship team, moving from 25th in 1988 to third in 1989.
What a thrill it's got to be for Sandy Woolsey to come home. Just a few years ago, she moved away to join the Desert Devils of Stormy Eaton down in Scottsdale, Arizona, but she grew up right here in Denver.
And Sandy really wants to put on a good show for her hometown crowd. Here's Sandy's combination. Two back handsprings to a layout pike back. And she's on, but it's not really that sharp.
Sandy was rolling right along at the American Cup in March just 4 months ago, and she looked like she was on her way to the top three. But this is where she had her problems, especially on the dismount of the balance beam.
That's right, Joel. In fact, Sandy's changed her dismount, opted for a safe dismount, the same one that Kim Zemeskal uses, a round off double back. And it was a nice, clean performance. Two steps on the landing, that would cost her 2 tenths.
She is so consistent and reliable that you always just count on Sandy Woolsey to come through. She's done it before for the U.S. national side, the world championships. And now competing, trying to make the U.S. national team in Denver, Colorado this weekend. We just saw the 9.675 on the vault for Shannon Miller. Currently in third position, Betty Aquino with her first attempt in the vault.
A layout pull. Betty uses the same vault Shannon Miller used. And this is the event where Betty has probably shown the most improvement. That was a great job. Nice high, little hop on the landing.
Bella has said that just over the last year, it's been a rapid rise for Betty Aquino.
Look at how aggressively she goes at this run. Strong round up onto the board, a big push, and beautiful form in the air. Just a little hop on the landing, that may be the mark of immaturity.
Betty Aquino accepting congratulations from her teammates, and that's got to be tough. They are teammates, they work out every day together. But at the same time, they're fierce competitors going up against each other. And a 9.7 of the vault for Elizabeth Betty Aquino. Sandy Woolsey, we just saw her on the balance beam. She came up with a 9.65 to maintain her position in the top five. Now the pressure mounts. Randy Johnson, our current leader, by only 0.05 of a point, gets ready for the balance beam. By far the most difficult apparatus.
Balance beam is a real pressure event, and Brandy is under pressure here to do a good job. The margin for error in this event is so small, the tiniest mistake, and you could be off. because she's off to a little bit of a shaky start, and she still has her most difficult elements coming up. Here's her combination, two back handsprings to a layout step out.
Problems for Brandi Johnson.
She is just off the beam. She just couldn't stay on. That second flip-flop was totally out of alignment.
And that is an automatic deduction of 0.5 point.
That
incredible.
Is just, that's a devastating miss for Brandi. You know, it's a shame when you give it away like that.
She has been the leader throughout the competition, and now on the second to last rotation, it begins to crumble.
Brandi still has a difficult element coming up. Front flip, that was nice and solid.
The degree of difficulty of that front flip seemed even more extreme than the one where she fell off.
That's right, Joel. You know, Brandi's had that combination, two back handsprings to a layout, for years now. That's never been a problem. That's a really unfortunate mistake. Here's her dismount. Nice, but she just won't be able to overcome that disastrous fall in the layout.
Well, Brandi Johnson has done everything that has been required of her so far until she got to the balance beam.
Okay. All right. Soft a little bit on her. Okay, now we'll get ready for floor. Okay, that's all that matters now. Let's get ready for floor. Okay, let's do it. Come on.
Her coach, Kevin Brown, trying to be as positive as possible. But now, her opportunity to win back-to-back championships may have just slipped away.
We'll see what went wrong here. First back handspring is on, second back handspring looks okay, and she goes for the layout, and she just goes crooked. She throws it a little crooked. And before she knows it, she's on the floor. Another look at that combination. She looks okay. She sets up, two back handsprings right into the layout. She's done the hard part. She looks like she has it, and she is just off. That is so surprising. You know, I've seen Brandi Johnson do that combination so many times. She should be able to do it in her sleep.
The reaction of her coach, Kevin Brown, all those hours training in the gym, possibly gone because of one fall on the balance beam.
Okay. Let's take a deep breath. Okay. That's all right. All right, now we just got to think about what we have to do. You go out and go after the floor now, all right? That's all that matters now.
Double park, second pass.
Okay.
She's asking her coach, Kevin Brown, if she can do a double tuck in her second pass. She's talking about her next event, the floor routine. She wants to water it down in the hopes that Kim Zemeskal will slip up.
A 9.325 for Brandi Johnson. Not bad when you consider that she fell off the beam. Zemeskal getting ready. Can she capitalize and take the lead? She needs a 9.4 to wrestle away the advantage from Brandi Johnson for the first time in the competition. She nailed it.
She did it. That was an unbelievable vault. That was excellent. The best vault we've seen in this competition.
This is one of the strongest apparatuses for Kim Zemeskal. What a time for her to take on the vault. And she really rose to the occasion because you have to be mentally tough to take advantage.
Kim saw the door open when Brandi fell off the balance beam, and she came in and capitalized on her opportunity. She performs a round off, layout full, the same vault Brandi Johnson does, but watch how this kid can do it. Round off, back handspring onto the horse, beautiful full, arches out early, and just floats to the floor. Incredible.
There is no step or bobble on her landing.
Kim Zemeskal is so tough. Strong full, arch out, and she just nails.
And how did the introverted Bella Caroli react to it?
Yeah!
Just another day at the office for Bella Caroli. As his gymnasts continue to dominate, and there's almost a perfect 10 for Kim Zemeskal. A 9.975. And she has catapulted herself into the lead. Brandi Johnson, on the other hand, deep in thought, contemplating what is to develop as she goes to the floor exercise for her final event. While the final rotation for our new leader, Kim Zemeskal, may be her weakest apparatus, the uneven bars. The drama continues when we return to Denver. Back to Denver as we take a look at the Results after three rotations with one event remaining. Zmeskal with the lead now by almost 5/10 of a point over Brandi Johnson. And here's where it all disintegrated for Brandi on the balance beam.
You know, Joel, the psychological aspect of the sport is so important, and it looked like Brandi just blanked out for just a moment here and was long enough to put her off the beam.
And the difference in the competition so far, 14-year-old Kim Zmeskal, mentally tough to take advantage of the opportunity.
When it comes down to it, Joel, this is the essence of gymnastics, hitting when it counts.
She's going to bars next. She can hit a 9/8 bars, okay? Or she might. Okay, now that you have to have your best floor team right now. This is where it's got to come out, okay? As far as making any verifications on any changes on anything there, we need to do a 10-0 routine. We need to go out there and nail a 10-0.
No more. Kimbo, keep your mind straight now. Hey, don't want that. No. Get hyper. One more to go. Strong. Is that right? It's gonna be a presidential. Ah, damn it.
A pressure-packed situation that's about to explode in the final rotation. Here's Betty Aquino, her final event on the uneven bars.
Betty has been such a surprise in this competition, and this is a great event for her to finish on. Here comes her first release. Big front flip, re-grasp. You know, she has such a long, lean body type, and she really looks terrific on this event. Second release, reverse act. She's working nicely, preparing for a dismount. It's an unusual dismount. Front with a half twist. It was very well done. The Crowleys must be very satisfied with her performance.
And with Brandi Johnson falling in the last rotation of the beam, it also is an opportunity for Betty Aquino to possibly slide up and move up in the standings. These championships have marked the emergence of Betty Aquino as a legitimate contender for the 92 Barcelona Olympics, and she had almost no international competition coming into the national championships this weekend. And when you look at the overall picture, Christy, most coaches feared that Bella Caroli was going to dominate the sport in future years. Well, that is truly unfolding now.
There's no doubt, Joel, that these girls, Bella Caroli's gymnasts, have been collectively picking up steam throughout the competition.
You can see Betty Aquino wincing a little bit over a 9-8, not satisfied with a 9-8. Incredible how intense the group is and how they challenge each other. Another Caroli protege, currently fifth, Erica Stokes, ready now for the uneven bars. And it continues with so much success for Caroli this weekend.
This is a great event for Erica Stokes. She swings extremely well, and she is a very powerful gymnast on this event. There's her first release, a ginger. She's working strong, aggressive. Second release, a beautiful reverse act. She's gearing up for a dismount, double tuck. Oh, and a rare mistake on that landing.
Right now, Caroli's girls are challenging each other. They're raising each other to that next level. And I've got to believe, Christy, that is going to pay dividends for Kim Zmeskal.
You're absolutely right, Joel. As a matter of fact, not only is it a psychological advantage for Kim coming into this event, seeing her teammates hit, but it's also setting the stage for the judges.
And that's a very interesting point, because right now, the consistency and the momentum that Aquino and the rest of the girls like Erica Stokes are putting together for Bella Caroli's gym, that's got to help the scoring down the road for Kim Zmeskal.
Here's a look at her dismount. She does a double tuck. She takes a big step on the landing, and it'll be interesting to see how much the judges penalize her for that error.
So Erica Stokes has completed the competition with a 9.75.
That is a perfect example of how a team can get on a roll, and even the judges are swept up in the momentum, and individuals benefit.
Now, the pressure rests on the shoulders of the defending champion, Brandi Johnson, trailing Kim Zmeskal. To have any kind of shot, she practically needs a 10.
Come on, Brandi. Come on, man.
Brandi Johnson is certainly capable of a 10 on this event. Her first pass may tell the story. She does a whip through to a full in back out, the most difficult pass being done in the competition. She's got it. Oh.
Both feet out of bounds, Christy. That's already 0.2 points deducted.
She's working for a 9.8 at this point.
Now, Christy, every time we saw her in March at the American Cup, she was short on her tumbling passes. There she went long.
Well, Joel, it looked like she had it. She simply bounced out of bounds. Well done, double back.
Much cleaner since that first pass, but the problems obviously are still continuing for Brandi Johnson. She was out of training for a while due to illness and injury. And we have seen over the last two rotations, the balance beam and now in the floor exercise. She is oh so close, but definitely she's not all the way back.
Brandi Johnson is a phenomenal athlete, and we need Brandi Johnson for the U.S. team, but we need Brandi Johnson in top shape.
Brandi now getting ready for final tumbling pass.
And she performs another double tuck, the same pass she used for a middle pass. Unfortunately for Brandi, that's another deduction.
And more and more now, it looks like Brandi Johnson may not be able to hold on to second place the all-around competition.
All right. Okay, good finish.
The disaster on the balance beam, followed by basically an average performance on the floor exercise.
Good finish, good and aggressive. Okay.
Here's where the problems began.
You can see Brandi does a whip through to her full in back out. That's more difficult than any of the other athletes in the competition. Nice high full in. Looks like she has it. And then she just hops right out of bounds. She just bounces out. As a coach, you hate that kind of error because she's already completed the difficult part. She's done the skill and then a mental error.
And her coach displaying his disappointment, Kevin Brown. So Brandi Johnson very close to making it all the way back, but it all unraveled over the final two rotations. And she may not be able to hold on to second place any longer. A 9.475.
That's a real shame for Brandi Johnson. She was a great champion. She led all the way through the competition until the final two events. What a disappointment.
So Brandi will definitely not defend her title at these gymnastics championships in Denver. The title is hers for the taking. That young lady, Kim Zemeskal. But she is about to take on her most difficult apparatus, the uneven bars, as we return to Denver. Championship with a 9.0 on the uneven bars, so all she needs to do is anything but fall off the apparatus, which she did twice, Christy, during warm-ups, and that's got to be in the back of her mind.
Kim's most difficult test will come on her first big release move.
Here it comes. She hung onto the bar, she came to a complete stop.
And that's a serious error. That's 0.3 points. She still has two difficult skills to go. Here comes her reverse hack. She's got it. She just has to nail her dismount.
Yes.
Beautiful. She's done it. She is our new national champion.
Did she ever stick that landing? Kim Zemeskal of Houston, Texas.
I was fighting for you. Hold on to it. Good job. Hold on to it. No matter, just don't let it go. All right, Bingo. All right, let it thank you.
All right. You still alive, President. At least for me.
The key words, hold on and don't let it go. She held on to the uneven bars. She is our new national champion.
I'm sure Bella Caroli, her coach, knew if she was going to have a problem, it was going to be on that first skill. And he told her, just hold on to the bar. And that's exactly what she did. She fought her way through that routine.
Let's look back now on that first nerve-wracking release. She's got good extension, good height.
This is where her troubles began. She bent her arms, dropped straight down between the bars, and nearly straight down off the bar as she completed the skill.
Fortunate to just simply hang on to the bar.
That was an incredible effort to stay on the bar. If you watch her hands as she completes the somersault, she reaches over the bar. The bar catches her at her wrists. And it nearly slides right out of her hands.
So she comes to the complete stop. She gets past that point of her routine, and now she's got to worry about the dismount.
And watch this, Joel. She goes at this dismount like she had no problems in the routine. She is really going great guns. Look at that. Way over the bar, layout, double pike.
She truly attacked that dismount.
She is such an aggressive gymnast.
And how did Bella Caroli react while all this was going on? Well, please pass the antacids.
You know, Bella's been in this position so many times before, but look at that. He's still nervous.
A new national champion. She needed a 9.0, and Kim Zemeskal has a 9.5.
Worked that even harder work, Kim? Yeah? Worked? Worked the work a little bit harder?
I know. It's worth it. I promise to you. It's worth it.
But I'm proud of you still.
You hear him mentioning to Kim Zemeskal, you'll work a little bit harder. Well, Bella has said that Phoebe Mills was the hardest worker he ever had. He also adds, though, that Kim Zemeskal is an extremely hard worker, very similar to Phoebe Mills.
Kim Zemeskal is a potential international medalist and a real asset to the American team.
We have a new national champion in Denver, Colorado. We'll meet Kim when we return. All over her face, and with good reason. There's our new national champion from Houston, Texas, Kim Zemeskal. And how does she stack up with other athletes from other areas of competition? Sean Bradley, who signed to play at BYU next year, is 7'6" tall. Compared to the number one pick in the NFL draft, Jeff George, at 6'3". And Kim Zemeskal, all of 4'5", weighing in at 72 pounds. And without a doubt, a champion in her own right. Let's look back now on the making of the champion in U.S. gymnastics. Olga, Nadja, Mary Lou. We knew them all by their first names. Who knows? Someday, we may all remember her simply as Kim. She's downstairs right now with Christy Kraft.
Okay, Kim, I want to congratulate you. It was a great performance.
Thank you.
I just want to know one thing. When Brandy fell off the beam and she opened the door for you to win the meet, were you aware of that, or what was going through your mind right then?
Well, at first I wasn't aware that she had fallen, and because we were still doing the 30-second touch for vault, and we came back, and I came back, and Amy said to me, you know, did you see that? And I was like, see what?
And then you found out, then you did a great vault, you went over to the uneven bars, and you had an error on the first skill, and you still had another release to go. What was going through your mind at that time?
Well, Bella told me to just make sure that I grabbed the bar and, you know, not make a major fall, and so that's what I did.
You did a great job. Kim, you are the American Cup winner. You're the senior national champion at 14 years old. Is this really what you expected coming into the meet?
Well, after compulsories, you know, I wasn't really sure because, you know, I was a little behind Brandy, and I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to pull up, but I did my best, and I did.
And your best was good enough, so congratulations and thanks.
Thank you.
The new queen of U.S. gymnastics, Kim Zemeskal. And let's take a look now at the final standings. The women's division, Zemeskal beating her teammate Betty Aquino, Brandy Johnson finishing third, Erica Stokes fourth, Sandy Woolsey fifth. So three of the top five from Bella Caroli's gym in Houston, Texas. She wears the crown and the smile well. Our new national champion. Thank you for joining us this afternoon in Denver, Colorado. For Tim Daggett and Christy Kraft, I'm Joel Myers. We'll see you once again tomorrow.